So according to the CDC and American Heart Association, 90% of Americans consume more salt than is recommended for a healthy diet. And too much sodium is hard on your health, among other things like your bones and brain. And to help us out here, Kowalski's dietitian Sue Morris is here to help us shake off the salts. Now,
yes.
You had mentioned the recommendation amount. 90% of Americans are getting too much salt. Can you show us a demonstration of what is too much salt in your diet?
Yeah, it's sort of surprising. Our body needs salt for many good things, including fluid balance and muscles contracting and relaxing, our nervous system. So it's needed, but we need very little. So we need 500 milligrams, which is that quarter teaspoon
so
of salt.
So this right here, that's
the what
daily.
Our body needs.
Okay, sure.
So it's an essential nutrient. We have to take it in, but we only need a quarter of a teaspoon.
Sure.
What we eat is over in this category, which is a teaspoon and a half.
Sure.
And what we should have, if you don't have heart problems, you don't have kidney issues or anything, then you want to be in this one teaspoon.
Okay, this seems like a very low amount, but I imagine like this amount of sodium is in most of the foods we eat, right? How do we get to this point?
Oh, great question. What's sort of interesting is salt is a little bit of a trained taste, and so we can retrain it back to not eat it. So we have, as salt has increased, we've sort of increased our appetite for it because your taste buds just get sort of linked in with, and you know, if you go out and you have a piece of cheesecake or whatever you're having and they hit it with just a touch of salt, you go, oh, because it hits the receptors in your brain and makes it just really enjoyable.
And before we came out to the show here, you were saying to always read the label, right? And you have two different types of oatmeal right here, and you said to look at the nutrition facts. What are you seeing here?
Well, what's so interesting is a food may seem salty, and you'd think, okay, I'll look for the label and whether condiments, that's a big category where we get a lot of salt. But when you go to foods that don't taste salty and you look at it and you go, oh, geez, how's that happen? So if you take a look at these two, one is regular oatmeal, just original flavored. And it has, good thing I brought glasses on, 75 milligrams.
That's this one right here, 75 milligrams.
Yep. But if you go to the maple brown sugar, take a look at that one and let us know what you see.
This one is 260 milligrams.
And it's not salty. So if you go ahead and bought the original and then added your own maple sugar and brown or maple sugar, maple syrup and brown sugar, you wouldn't add any sodium.
How about that?
So it's really taking a look at those labels because you'll find, you know, pizza, just these two slices of pizza, 900 milligrams. And we're supposed to have, this is 2,300.
2,300, 900, just in those two.
Good to know is that 70% of the sodium that we get comes from the food that we eat that's sort of packaged. 11% comes from what we add on. And 15% is naturally in.
Okay, so what can we do to help substitute in some? Let's do the change. How can we reduce our sodium intake?
Okay, so first of all, if you're a salt user, change up your salt. So if you do a difference between these two salt, just kosher salt versus this regular salt, 20% difference.
There we go.
This is less. Kosher is less.
Kosher is less salt.
Yep. You can do herbs and spices, which are great medicinally, give tons of flavor, and you don't have any sodium in them. Cooking wine, lemon and lime, perfect. If you rinse foods like canned beans, canned vegetables, fish, 25 to 40% of the sodium you can wash off.
Okay.
And all of those things are going into foods that are going to have other flavors. You would never notice the difference.
Sure. I've heard a lot about coconut aminos. Is that a good substitute for soy sauce?
Yep. It's still got some sodium.
Sure.
But it's a great change out to bring it all down. And all of these little measures add up to a big difference.
How about that?
You have a question. Bring it on.
Always have a question.
Quick question.
Sorry. How do you feel, how does the body feel when you intake significantly less salt? Like, what are we feeling that will change?
I don't think you'd really feel much at all because it's a trained taste in terms of you can tick it back. And it usually takes about 4 weeks for you to be able to change the flavor of, or change your taste buds to appreciate it. And then when you have something salty, you go, whoa, that was kind of salty.
I was just going to say that. Yeah. Now I taste salt.
Yes.
Before that, I never tasted salt.
You get acclimated to it.
Now, if there's a little extra salt in my meal, I taste salt.
Yeah. You're salt blind.
And the one thing I'd say is a big way to change this is to up your potassium. And that's these foods here. So fruits and vegetables, great. Beans are great. Just rinse them. Yeah. Dairy foods. But if you up your fruits and vegetables, sodium and potassium work like a teeter-totter. So if you're up high on sodium, And if you don't have heart or kidney issues, if you bring up the potassium, it sort of meets it out and makes it better. And only 2% of us get as much potassium as we should.
Wow.
So bring on the potassium and you sort of give yourself a little bit more wiggle room to enjoy your pizza, but have it with a spinach salad or potato salad or anything like that.
Thank you for making us a little smarter. This is awesome. So all of Sue's advice and information is at care11.com, along with a link to Kowalski's.